Hello you beautiful people, this is Chris from Macombu and this is my final unboxing of 2018, the Oppo RX17 Pro. It's a premium device which we went hands-on with at the official RX17 Pro launch recently. It comes packed with an in-display fingerprint sensor, quite premium specs, and all kinds of interesting features including a dual battery arrangement. As you can see, the box has got a wee bit banged up on its way over from merry old China, but hopefully the actual phone itself will be alright, touch wood. You can see a similar sort of box to the likes of the Oppo Find X, just slides on out all neat like so. There's the actual phone itself. We'll just stick that aside for a second and check out what else you get inside the box, of course, because it'd be a bit of a crap unboxing without that. So first up in here, you do of course get a lovely transparent cover. Look at that, it's got lovely blue tint to it, presumably to match the blue hue of the actual smartphone itself. And of course you get usual pamphlets which tell you all about the Oppo RX17 Pro, exciting times, and naturally your little pokey pin device in order to get your SIM in there. We'll actually be making use of that. You also get a Super VOOC charger, brilliant name. I'll tell you more about Super VOOC in a bit. It's some quite interesting battery charging tech, and it looks like you also get a nice bit of inner ear headphone action as well. Always a nice addition. They are Type C USB phones as well, because the actual RX17 Pro doesn't come with a 3.5mm headphone jack. So at least you don't have to use a dongle straight out of the box, which is always good. And of course you get your Type-C USB charger cable as well. Isn't that thrilling, kiddies? There you go, so not a bad little box there. You get the cover, the headphones, the few little bits that you wouldn't get as standard. All right, let's grab out the stuff I need and then let's have a little bit of a tour of the phone. So first of all, just peel off the protective sheath. And there is the RX17 Pro in all of its glory. So this is the sort of the subtle turquoise tinty version. You can also get it in, I believe it was something like a misty, frosty blue or something like that, which looked quite nice. It was kind of like a gradient style finish that you would get on the likes of the Huawei smartphones. But I do like this subtle turquoise, it's very nice. Reminds me of the subtle purple version of the Oppo Find X, which again was very smart, very sleek. Now, 3D misty glass surfacing seems to be doing a pretty good job of hiding smudges and scuffs. Normally these glass rears, they get all scuffed and grimy in no time at all. You can see a little bit of dust settling on the surface, but honestly, it's not that bad at all. Nice bit of Oppo branding there underneath the tri-lens camera setup. We'll be diving into the specifics on that in a bit, teaser teaser. The rest of the design is pretty standard, of course. You've got your usual power and volume controls here on this side. You've got your SIM tray, your USB, and your speaker down below, and then just the power button on this side. Hopefully we'll have some juice in the tank and we'll be able to get it all set up and have a tour of the software. Yes, there we go. So I'm gonna slam my SIM card into the Oppo RX17 Pro and then we'll run through all the specs and the best features. So as you can see there, quite a simple SIM tray, at least at first appearance anyway. There's no room for a micro SD memory card, but it is actually a dual SIM. You can slip in one SIM card on one side and a second SIM card on the other side, which is pretty nifty. And it does clearly mark which one is SIM 1 and SIM 2. I say clearly mark, you have to have eyes like a friggin' hawk in order to read that tiny text, but there you go. Right, I've entered my Google details and all that other bollocks, and now it's time to do a bit of the security shenanigans. First of all, of course, it's got full facial recognition, a feature you'd pretty much expect from a modern day smartphone. And let's turn on the raise to turn on screen feature as well. So all you've got to do is just pick up the phone, it recognizes your mug and you're immediately into your desktops. And as you can see, of course, I have that in-screen fingerprint sensor as well, based down here towards the bottom of the display. So let's just add my fingerprint as well, and then we can give those both a bit of a testing out. It seemed to work absolutely fine in our hands-on session with the Oppo RX17 Pro out in, where on earth was that again? Somewhere in Germany, I think. I know it was Milan, I tell a lie. I'm such a jet setter, they all blend into one. So he's gonna try holding this a couple of different ways and get this registered. Right, that should be that done. Set up as a new Oppo phone. I've already done the Android backup restore anyway. And of course, as you can see, a bit of ColorOS 5, version 5.2 to be specific, I do believe. Tell me I can get rid of this stupid Google bar, doesn't look like it. Oh no. There we go, let's just ditch that. Now when I went hands-on with the Oppo RX17 Pro, ColorOS 5.2 was sat on top of Android version Oreo. And indeed, that is still the case, version 8.1.0. Hopefully we'll have a full update to Android Pie in the new year in 2019, fingers crossed. As you can see, it adds all of the usual standard ColorOS features. You can go check out our full ColorOS tips and tricks with, I believe it was the Oppo F9 and the Oppo Find X, to see sort of more of the in-depth details on some of the best features. But as you can see, all your sort of standard Android stuff and quite a few bonus bits on top. So for instance, Do Not Disturb, you've got the likes of Quiet Time in here, which you can enable to come on automatically in the evenings. Just keep annoying gits from ruining your beauty sleep. Of course, you've got all the usual fingerprint and face recognition stuff. In Smart and Convenient section, you can change up the navigation, you can play with the navigation bar. You can also get some gesture control on the go as well. Gamers have the Game Space feature as well. As you can see there, it actually has the Game Assistant, which allows you to improve the general performance. You can also prevent any annoying background apps from nicking your networking. You can also prevent any background apps from stealing all of your network access as well. So the likes of PUBG Mobile, that game will be prioritized online. So plenty of stuff to get your chops around. Unfortunately, there is no apps tray, as you can see there, which is rather annoying. And of course, ColorOS does have a fair few little quirks with it as well. It's one of those love it or hate it things, or just be generally sort of ambivalent about it, I guess. Let's just quickly test out the security options on the RX17 Pro as well. So first of all, of course, you've got face unlocks. You can just directly lift the phone. It's recognized my face, as you can see now, says swipe up to open. So there you go. If you actually dive into the settings and go to that fingerprint, face and passcode section, there is thankfully an option to directly unlock the phone just with your face to avoid that swiping, something that Apple still doesn't offer with its latest iPhone. So now if we lift it up and boom, you're straight into your desktops. And of course, there is that fingerprint sensor built into the display as well. So hopefully if we just give a quick tap, there we go, boom, again, straight into the desktops. It is a bit of a learning curve for these in-screen fingerprint sensors. You've got to learn just the right amount of pressure to apply. With the RX17 Pro, it seems to be quite light pressure. So if you actually force your print onto it, no, it still works actually. Fair play. So let's run through some of the other specs of the RX17 Pro as well. The display itself is a 6.4 inch Full HD Plus OLED panel. So you get nice punchy colors. It's nice and crisp as well with that Full HD Plus resolution. As you can see, a bit of dewdrop notch action up top as well. Nothing too intrusive, just kind of dangling there like a mini scrotum. Go into the settings, go into the display section. There's a bit of customization you can do in there as well. As you can see, fiddle around with the likes of the night shield feature, which just filters the blue light at night. Let's just change the auto screen feature. And as you can see, you can also mess around with the likes of this color temperature to make it nice and warm or nice and cool. And then your preference. You can also, of course, play around with themes and the wallpapers and everything as well. But sadly, there is still no ability to add an apps tray, which is really annoying. What's actually powering the RX17 Pro? Well, it's a Snapdragon 710 chipset. Bit of a shame that it's not the 845, given that it is a premium priced device. We haven't got the specific UK price. Some UK online retailers seem to be it's costing it at around the sort of £570 price point, which is basically a match for the €599 official price point direct from Oppo. But of course, that does mean the likes of the OnePlus 6T is more affordable, and it's got that Snapdragon 845 chipset, which makes it a bit of a strong rival. Still, you do get 6 GB of RAM on the Oppo RX17 Pro as well. And as you can see, apps are loading up pretty quickly. No real issue there. So there doesn't seem to be anything in the way of slowdown or anything like that. So fingers crossed, with a good bit of everyday use and when gaming with the likes of PUBG, should hopefully hold its own. As for the storage, I believe it comes with 128 gigs of storage packed in there, which is in the additional settings, confusingly. Yep, and 102 gigs of that is available right now, but of course it started installing a bunch of my apps from a previous backups, the likes of PUBG and stuff, so you do get quite a bit of space on there, but not expandable, sadly. What's really intriguing me is, of course, the battery tech, because it doesn't just have a single 3,700 milliamp cell, as some sites and YouTube channels are reporting. It's actually a dual battery setup, so you've got two 1850 milliamp batteries packed inside. And what Oppo reckons is that basically combined with the Super VOOC charge, and you'll be able to get up to 40% battery life, so close to what we've got right now, in just 10 minutes at the plug, which will be quite incredible if it's actually accurate. Will that be the case? Well, stay tuned for our in-depth Oppo RX17 Pro review to find out. And of course, you've got usual power saver modes and everything as well, and you can also see power consumption details all in caps. Which brings us nicely onto the camera tech, and again, one of the more intriguing features of the Oppo RX17 Pro, and something that might set it apart from rivals, potentially. So what you have here is a 12 megapixel primary lens. It's an f1.5 to f2.4 aperture. It automatically adapts depending on the situation, kind of similar to what we've seen on some Samsung flagship phones. And that's backed by a 20 megapixel f2.6 secondary lens as well. But you also get this third interesting little lens here. It's a ToF stereo camera. And what that can do is it can accurately measure the distance between the phone and any object. That's apparently going to be used for all kinds of AR shenanigans and the likes, which we haven't actually been able to test out yet because it's not currently active. But hopefully, all that shenanigans will be coming soon in an update. Oppo reckons early 2019 couldn't be any more accurate than that. But as you can see at the moment, you get your standard array of features. You've got photo, you've got video, you can shoot up to 4K resolution video. It does, of course, start in good old full HD. You've also got slow motion abilities as well. You've got your expert mode, which is basically like a professional manual mode. You can fully play around with all kinds of stuff like the ISO levels, the shutter speed, autofocus, things like that. Let's just get out of here. And of course, you've got your portrait mode using the dual lens setup in order to lock on your subject, keep them nice and crisp while blurring the background. And of course, you've got various studio lighting modes as well, because that's all the fashion now. Thanks, Apple. You got night mode as well, which we'll be looking forward to testing out, because one of the taglines of the Oppo RX17 Pro is capture the night. So let's see if it does that. And of course, you've got your sticker crap as well, so you can give yourself a little head scarf thing, turn yourself into a polar bear, whatever life ambitions you may have in particular. As for around the front, it's a 25 megapixel front facing selfie camera. Let's just get it back into photo mode. And then, oh yeah, flip, there we go. So yeah, as I say, a 25 megapixel snapper, so it should capture nice crisp shots of your gorgeous mug. As you can see there, it's recognizing my face. Hopefully should be able to jump into portrait mode. There we go. So you can shoot a portrait mode effort using that front facing camera as well. And yes, once again, you get all of this random sticker bollocks. What am I doing there? I'm cooking an egg. Great. I don't understand why that's a thing. Love. Cakes, things, I don't know what the my one wish for 2019 is that this just dies a death. It's not going to happen though, is it? So that in a nutshell right there is the RX17 Pro. I've got my SIM in there. I'm going to be using it as my full-time smartphone. So stay tuned for an in-depth review of that bad boy as well. Come probably be early 2019 now. So happy holidays, everyone. Or if this video goes live after the holidays, happy 2019, I guess. Don't forget to poke, subscribe, and ding that notifications bell for more on the latest and greatest mobile tech. And as always, love you, bye.